Hello, and welcome to this video on creating a virtual machine from a template using Oracle Linux Virtualization Manager. In this video, you will learn how to create a virtual machine from a template using the Oracle Linux Virtualization Manager administration portal. Let's get started. We are logged into the Oracle Linux Virtualization Manager administration portal, and from the menu, we have already navigated to Compute and then Templates. This brings us to the Templates list. The templates list currently shows two templates created from Oracle Linux virtual machines and the blank template. The blank template, which is decoupled from all clusters and data centers, is editable but not deletable. To create a new virtual machine from a template, we first select the OL7-VM-template in the list and then click the New VM button. The new virtual machine dialog box opens, displaying the General tab by default. For the cluster selection, since the default cluster is the only cluster in our environment, we'll leave it selected. For template, it shows the name of the template we highlighted in the list before opening the new virtual machine dialog window. This is the template we want to base the new VM on, so we leave it selected. For the operating system, Oracle Linux 7.x86 is already selected from the drop-down list, as this is what was used in the VM that the template was created from, so we leave it selected. For the instance type, it shows custom. This represents the shape of the VM that the template was created from, indicating the number of CPUs, memory, etc. This is good for our new VM, so we leave custom type selected. The same applies for the optimized for dropdown, which shows desktop is selected. For the name field, we paste in OL7-VM2 for its name. We then check to ensure a VNIC profile is selected. So looking at the VNIC profile section, we see from the NIC1 drop-down list the logical network VM-NET, which we will use. To boot the new VM, we need to ensure that the first device is set to hard disk, so we click the Boot Options tab in the window to verify. We see it is correctly chosen from the template to be hard disk. When the template was built using another VM as reference, a read-only copy of the disk belonging to the VM was created. This template disk is used to build the hard disk for the new VM. We now have enough information set in the new virtual machine dialog, so we click OK to create the virtual machine from the template. The length of time it takes to create varies depending on the size of the virtual machine. To see the new virtual machine when it's created, we select Compute from the navigation menu and then Virtual Machines. This shows a list of all VMs, now with our new VM included. For our new virtual machine, OL7-VM2, the status column shows image lock and an hourglass icon indicating the new VM is still being created. After some time, we get a notification message telling us the new VM has been created, with the status showing down and a red arrow icon. We click Dismiss All to remove the notification. With our new VM already highlighted, we click Run to boot the virtual machine. The red arrow icon to the left of the virtual machine turns green and the status column displays Wait for launch. As the VM starts, the status changes to powering up, and we start seeing memory, CPU, and uptime statistics. After it is up and running, the status changes to up, and a notification message tells us the VM machine is finished launching. To access the VM console, we click on the console button. This will open a terminal window on the desktop of our VM. And here is our VM, with the terminal window opened. We can see the new VM built from the template is running and ready to be used. In this video, you learned how to create a virtual machine from a template using the Oracle Linux Virtualization Manager administration portal. Oracle provides an extensive number of resources which you can use to find out more about this subject and others. For more videos on Oracle Linux Virtualization Manager, go to the Learning Library link shown. To view an extensive collection of training content covering a range of administrative topics on Oracle Linux, go to the Oracle Linux Learning Library. You can find documentation on Oracle Linux Virtualization Manager at the link shown. There is a comprehensive Oracle Linux curriculum available to support a full range of Linux administration skills for cloud, on-premise, and hybrid users. For more information or to get started on Oracle Cloud Infrastructure, go to cloud.oracle.com. And for more training on Linux and Oracle Cloud Infrastructure, go to the link shown here. That's the end of the video. Thanks for watching.